So class, now we are going to have our discussion on our topic 4 of UPSC syllabus, that is sociologist, or you can say sociological thinkers. In your syllabus, we are going to understand Marx. Full name is Karl Marx. How many of you know Karl Marx? Karl Marx period 1818 to 1883, right? This is a basic information. Belongs to Germany, right? We have already discussed in our topic 1, and what was that topic? Emergence of sociology in Europe. And we have now, at least we have got peripheral information, understanding of Karl Marx. We are going to begin from there only, okay? And then we are trying to understand Karl Marx now in depth, okay? As I said, that whensoever you want to understand any subject and you want to have concrete information about any topic, have a good understanding, that is, like, you know, in step 1, you must have basic information. For example, that we come to know during during our orientation classes, we have broadly discussed about sociology. Okay, now you need to correlate your one of the important thinkers in a sociological manner. Okay, we know, and I've already explained to all of you that how sociologists in 18th, 19th century, what they actually endeavor to understand about that the chaos, okay, about the changes, disrupt rapid changes which took place, okay, and they all worked to bring back that social order again. Karl Marx is being misunderstood by many, you know, by many that he was against capitalism, or he wanted to have a, you know, revolutions. In this topic, we are going to go beyond such assumptions and we are going to understand Karl Marx critically. Good morning, Shubham. Okay, so first of all, we are going to have a basic correlation about Karl Marx, what we had already read in topic 1. I have explained to all of you that whensoever you are understanding about sociology, and you need to, I know that you all have to complete your syllabus, but try to comprehend sociology optional in a manner that it is very much clear in your head, like a narrative. What is narrative? Like a story, where you do not have to think that what is there in the topic 1, what is there in the topic 2 or topic 3, topic 4. I know that after giving sectional test, after giving test series, you people know what is there in the syllabus. But the idea here in my class is to make you, like, you know, this much, I want to train you this much, that you become very, you people have strong base for sociology, where you do not even have to think how sociology has emerged and how sociology is basically an outcome of modernity, or how sociology is different from other social sciences, what its relationship, how sociology and common sense is there, what is similarities, what is differences, and then sociology as science or research methods. Okay, so today we are going to deal Karl Marx in a story manner. Okay, because when we try to put extra efforts, right, when we try to put extra efforts to understand any thinkers, it becomes really difficult for all of you to learn them. As you know that in UPSC, you're not only dealing with sociology, there are a lot many subjects. So how the vastness of UPSC syllabus can be, you can say, can be conquered. We can conquer and we can win in this journey of UPSC, and the struggle which we all face is the vastness. So vastness can be, you can say, vastness can be controlled, or we can deal with vastness if we can have a correlations, interconnection, if we can make interconnections, okay, interdisciplinary approach, I would say. We do not have to put lot of extra efforts, okay, where it comes naturally, where you should understand sociology, it should become, it's like a very common sense knowledge to all of you, that you already know what Karl Marx, you know what Durkheim, you know how modernity is, and how it comes when you keep on repeating. If you see and if you can understand, it is very much cleared by various scientific research and reports that whosoever, you know, makes success or they are successful, it is because of their habits. Okay, athlete become an athlete because he has a habit of doing a lot of fitness and running before the D-Day. Any player, you know, in a, you can say, worldwide champions, you must know about their habits. Habits include everything, eating, you know, sleeping, what they think and all. So if you want to win over sociology, I would say, you need to work on habit. And now you must be thinking, what ma'am is saying, what habit we can inculcate in sociology? Habit is what? Which, how habit forms? When we do something repetitively, so when we do something repetitively, we get, you know, we become very, our brain become very, you know, that information become very natural to us and it comes automatically. For example, when we wake up, it's become our habit. We brush our teeth, or someone who wants to take drink or a green tea whatsoever, it becomes a habit, right? It becomes a habit. So similarly, what I'm trying to tell you, that make your habit to have a correlation, to know how this sociology can become easy in your mind. So take the element of repetition. What happens when we do revise? What happened with revision? With revision, we have set of information. We have, you know, some topics whatsoever we are reading, and when we are revising it, learning it, it becomes very natural to us. We do not have to think like that. So today now I'll begin my session with this approach. Okay. Now, of course, we are dealing with Karl Marx and we are going to understand him in a very deeper manner. So focus has to be on our syllabus, definitely. So see your syllabus and tell me, what are the topics which you believe is very much important, and we already had a discussion. It says historical materialism. Right? Then we have mode of production. Then we have class struggle. right? Then we have alienation. This is the way syllabus goes, right? Please see and check in the syllabus. Is there any topic left? Okay. Now, let's deal with in a story manner. Narrative or story of Karl Marx. Okay. So Karl Marx is writing in which period? 18th-19th century. 18th to 19th century. Now, what you have to do, you need to correlate it with your topic one, that is modernity. Okay? Modernity. We are dealing with that, okay, Karl Marx is writing in a time where world is going through the process of modernity. And we already know and just relate in your mind that whatsoever discussion we had made in our topic one. And what is that? Modernity, social changes, and then it is emergence of sociology, right? In the emergence of sociology, we have already discussed about Karl Marx, we have already discussed about mode of production, we have already discussed alienation and all. Now we are just going to quickly recall our information. So it is 18th-19th century where world was going through modernity, and modernity we have known that it is through Renaissance, right? Then keep telling me. After Renaissance, what comes? What are the factors of modernity, guys? Quickly. It's Enlightenment. Then we have French and Industrial Revolution. All this factor brought us to modernity. Modernity means new social order. New social order, that means it came because of these changes. So now new social order is bringing social changes. And what are they? It has introduced world to new economical system. Where human labor got replaced by machines, and technologies right. Now, this new economical created new location of work, that is city, and down that further leads to slum areas. The slum areas, the city town gave us lethal poverty, right? It gave us lethal poverty, slum areas, lethal poverty, and lot many challenges. Death rate got increased. Challenges to human survival. Right? Okay. These are the background of modernity. Now we need to see Karl Marx's role. Karl Marx was, his parents was middle class people, I mean coming from good family. But when he came to England, right, when he left his place to Germany, he saw anarchy in the world. What do we mean by anarchy? Where old structure is broken. So where we had one set of rules and regulation to live our life, okay, where we know about feudal structure, where we were dependent on agriculture, okay? So old structure or old structure at that point of time, which was based on agriculture, which has feudal relation, okay? Where you have lord, feudal lords and serfs, or you can say peasants, where it was small scale production, where people were skilled to produce their own things. People were skilled to produce necessities of life without technologies, or you can say advanced technologies. Richard, so discoveries led by James Hargreaves and lot many other discoveries coming out of science. And technologies have changed what have changed economical production, have broadly changed economical production. Right? So Karl Marx was deeply disturbed, perturbed by such changes because there was a chaos, there was anarchy in society where majority of people have started coming under poverty. And it was absolute poverty. Okay? So what is now happening? Karl Marx, being philosopher, and he was basically, you can say, he had a very strong empathy for society. He wanted to know that what's going on in the world. Okay? And he wants to bring stability in society, like all philosophers they do. So what all philosophers do, all philosophers try to understand society from their respective lenses for the promotion of good for society as a whole. Philosophy, whether it's religious philosophy, whether it's biological philosophy or natural science philosophies, whatsoever it is only for bringing cohesion in society. So Karl Marx have used which perspective? He has used economical perspective. Okay? And in that process, he formulated theories which supports and says that how economical production, how economical engagements of humans in their lives leads to changes in the world at massive level. So Karl Marx is also analyzing these rapid changes which occurred in 18th-19th century. Is this clear? So what is now happening? Tell me. What is happening in the 18th-19th century? This is clear to all of you? Okay. Now, let's just see again Karl Marx. So basic personality of Karl Marx and his approach. Karl Marx was vocal, radical. Okay? So his approach was radical. And you can say personality wise, He were empath. Okay. Who thinks for society. And particularly vulnerable section. He was deeply influenced by and inhuman conditions living in it. In Germany, because of his radical thoughts, he needed to leave. Okay, he has to leave Germany, and then he had started writing about what? About economical condition and about, like, you know, that how it is bringing social problems in society. Okay, so he had to leave Germany because of his radical thoughts. So who are radicals? Radicals who want complete change, replacement. So if you are not happy with current state, then replace it. Okay, so radical are very, what they are, they believe in replacement. Okay, so Karl Marx needs to be understood in a sociological manner. Okay, now, so the first debate is whether Karl Marx was a sociologist. Was he a sociologist? Was Karl Marx a sociologist? Because sociologist, if we see the you know, established definition of sociology, they try to understand society in a scientific manner. This is what Auguste Comte, Emile Durkheim, right, have explained. So who are sociologists? Who try to understand society in a scientific manner, like a pathologist who tries to see what is happening in society. But we have seen that Karl Marx was radical. He wants to play a role of bringing, he wants to tell that, okay, revolution should take place. There should be, you know, what they should, the current system has to replace. Fine. So now, first of all, we need to have clarity that whether he was a sociologist or not. And in understanding that, we need to know who are sociologists. Sociologists, by definition, are those who try to understand society. They analyze, explore, and basically they deal with social static and dynamics. Okay, Karl Marx is one such thinker in the world who had been studied in all the discourse of the, you know, academics. In all the discourses of knowledge, Karl Marx is being studied. There is not a single paradigm or there is not a single aspect where Karl Marx's views cannot be interpreted. Okay, Karl Marx never called him a sociologist. Okay, he never said that he was a sociologist or he wants to understand society and all. Okay, so now we need to see that sociologists are basically, they want to understand social changes and they only recommend that, okay, this is what happening. For example, Emile Durkheim have recommended. What Emile Durkheim have recommended? That sociologists should become social physicians, where sociologists should understand these are the problems and they must recommend some solutions to the problem. This is what Emile Durkheim have said. right? This is what earlier French sociologists have also said. But here, Karl Marx is bringing and telling about, you know, revolutions. Okay? It is not that only he is talking about revolution, that's why he is not considered as a sociologist. Okay? He is simply bringing that, okay, these are the problems and this can be replaced only if we can have dominant position in society, in economical, in the relation of production, which I'm going to explain later on. It should have some control. And he was not only thinking, but he was actually dreaming also that one day there will be a revolution where proletariat will replace bourgeoisie, which later we know that it did not come true. So he was a dreamer also. Okay? So Karl Marx, whether he was a sociologist or not, we have two school of thought. Okay? So one school of thought rejects it. And other school accept Karl Marx as sociologist. Okay? Now in this line, you people have to write some write-up. So write down now. These are the basic information, okay? So what are the points you must write down in this answer? So Karl Marx spoke on every aspect of society. Keep writing all this point. Karl Marx spoke on Karl Marx spoke on every aspect of society. Karl Marx's ideas are applicable to various disciplines. Okay. However, in the discipline of sociology, Karl Marx is not considered as sociologist. Okay, so we are dealing with whether Karl Marx was a sociologist. So one school rejects, other school accept. Karl Marx is one such philosopher who spoke on all the aspects of society. Ideas are applicable to various disciplines such as political science, right? About philosophy, history, okay? Sociology, anthropology. So Karl Marx, by various social thinkers, so however in the discipline of sociology, Karl Marx is not considered as a sociologist by various social thinkers. Okay. Written specifically by those who comprehends society by positivist approach. Okay, by positivist approach. So what are positivist approach? Again, for your explanation, I'm repeating. अभी हम लोगों ने डिस्कस किया है ना पॉजिटिविस्ट अप्रोच इन टॉपिक टू. अब हम क्या कर रहे हैं, सी वी आर कमिंग टू आवर व्हाट वी हैव डूइंग नाउ. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मॉडर्निटी, सोशल चेंजेस, इमर्जेंस ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी. नाउ यस, नाउ वी आर ऑल्सो सेइंग दैट हाउ कार्ल मार्क्स इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड बाय लाइक यू नो इज नॉट अ सोशियोलॉजिस्ट. सो दैट्स मीन दैट वी आर ऑल्सो डिस्कसिंग फॉर्मलिस्टिक स्कूल and synthetic school. Now we are saying that why he was not considered as sociologist. So he was not considered as sociologist by particular school of thought, that is positivist. Here earlier I have discussed now that one school rejects, so who are that positivist. And we have discussed about positivist philosophy in topic 2. What is topic 2? Sociology and science. This is very important. You must know, you must have clarity on this. Okay. So, positivist, what they argue? We need to use. What? Who are positivists? Guys, tell me. Abhishek, Ananya, Brahm, Deveshwar, Disha, Chakravarti, Brena, Shubham. So what is scientific? What positivist says? If I want to say in a very easy language, so positivist ka kya maanna hai? Batao. Pura topic 2, topic 3 khatam ho gaya hai na? Yes. Quickly, online aspirants. समाज में कार्ल मार्क्स को हम सोशियोलॉजिस्ट मानेंगे कि नहीं मानेंगे? समाज बदल रहा है 18-19 सेंचुरी में, ये तो हमको समझ में आ गया. कैसे बदल रहा है? इकोनॉमिकल प्रोडक्शन चेंज हो गया, फैक्ट्रीज आ गई, मशीनरीज आ गई. ओके, फैक्ट्रीज और मशीनरीज से सारे एस्पेक्ट्स रैपिडली चेंजेस हो रहे हैं. तो पॉजिटिविस्ट का क्या मानना था? पॉजिटिविस्ट कौन थे? इमैनुअल डर्खाइम, ऑगस्ट कॉम्टे, सेंट सिमोन. सो पॉजिटिविस्ट से कार्ल मार्क्स कहाँ के हैं? जर्मनी. ठीक है, जर्मनी में जो जर्मनी की स्कूल ऑफ थॉट है वो एक्चुअली कहाँ से ओरिएंटेड है? वैल्यूज, फिलोसफीज और हम देख चुके हैं टॉपिक 2 में डिबेट ऑन पॉजिटिविस्ट एंड एंटी पॉजिटिविस्ट. तो पॉजिटिविस्ट का मानना है दैट सोशल वर्ल्ड शुड बी स्टडी जस्ट लाइक natural world. ठीक है, जैसे आप नेचुरल फिनोमिनन के लिए रिसर्च करते हो, वैसे ही आप सोशल फिनोमिनन के लिए रिसर्च करो। यह है पॉजिटिविस्ट अप्रोच। एंटी पॉजिटिविस्ट का मानना है, क्योंकि हम समाज के बारे में डील कर रहे हैं, सोशल वर्ल्ड के बारे में डील कर रहे हैं, तो ह्यूमंस का इन्वॉल्वमेंट होना चाहिए, ह्यूमंस का थॉट प्रोसेस हमको काउंट करना है। बट कार्ल मार्क्स इन दोनों में से किसी के बारे में ऐसी बात नहीं कर रहे, मेथड्स के बारे में बात नहीं कर रहे। तो कार्ल मार्क्स क्या बोल रहे हैं, दैट हमको समाज को पढ़ना है, समझना है इकोनॉमिकल कंडीशंस के थ्रू। कार्ल मार्क्स इज सेइंग के समाज में चेंज देखो, और हिस्ट्री, हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म एज अ टूल उन्होंने यूज किया, अभी हम पढ़ेंगे, ठीक है। हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है उन्होंने टूल की तरह यूज किया, ओके। हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म, ही बोरोड हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म फ्रॉम विच थिंकर्स, हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म करवाया था इमर्जेंस ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी में, राइट। तो हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म में कौन से दो थिंकर्स हैं जिनसे कार्ल मार्क्स गॉट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड, डायलेक्टिक्स। तो डायलेक्टिक्स कहां से बोरो किया, गाइस, प्रेरणा चक्रवर्ती, दिशा, अनन्या, अभिषेक, हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म लिखवाया था, टेल मी, पीछे नोट्स देख सकते हो, प्लीज सी योर नोट्स। तो ही बोरोड फ्रॉम डायलेक्टिक कॉन्सेप्ट फ्रॉम हूम, सिंथेसिस, थीसिस, हेगल, फ्रेडरिक हेगल, और ही यूज डायलेक्टिक्स, हेगल से उन्होंने कॉन्सेप्ट लिया, ऑलराइट। तो यहां पे समझना है पॉजिटिविस्ट अप्रोच का कहना था कि कार्ल मार्क्स सोशियोलॉजिस्ट नहीं है। पॉजिटिविस्ट कौन है, जो कहते हैं कि जिस तरीके से हम रेन को समझते हैं, अर्थ को समझ रहे हैं, ग्रेविटी समझ रहे हैं, आसमान समझ रहे हैं, जो भी हमारा नेचुरल वर्ल्ड है जिसमें हम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स करते हैं, ट्रुथ देखते हैं, वैसे ही हम इसको समझे। बट व्हाट पॉजिटिविस्ट वर सेइंग कि कार्ल मार्क्स की थ्योरी जो है वो साइंटिफिक नहीं है। तो उन्होंने रिजेक्ट क्यों किया, सबसे पहले किसने रिजेक्ट किया उनको एज अ सोशियोलॉजिस्ट, पॉजिटिविस्ट ने, ठीक है। पॉजिटिविस्ट ने कहा कि नहीं, ये सोशियोलॉजिस्ट नहीं हो सकते। क्यों नहीं हो सकते भाई, अच्छा तो तुम जो पॉइंट बोल रहे हो वो बिल्कुल ठीक है, अभी मैंने ये बताया भी नहीं है। तो देखो, जब आप सुनने की कोशिश करोगे ना फोकस होके, तो आपको सब समझ में आएगा, ओके, बिल्कुल आप ठीक कह रहे हो। तो पुअर आप बोल रहे हो क्योंकि वो पुअर्स की तरफ बात करना चाह रहे थे, तो पुअर की तरफ बात करने में प्रॉब्लम क्या है, क्या नहीं होना चाहिए, हाँ बताओ क्या नहीं होना चाहिए, यू आर बायस नहीं होना चाहिए। तो बायस इंसान कैसे होता है, वेरी गुड, व्हाट्स योर नेम, मैं भूल गई तुम्हारा नाम, हाँ निशान, तुमने अभी ज्वाइन किया है ना। तो अब देखो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, जब क्लास में फोकस होके सुनोगे आपको कोरिलेशन बनाना आ जाएगा, बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हो। अभी मैं आपको बिल्कुल करेक्ट आंसर बताऊंगी। पहले आपने क्या बोला, किड्स पुअर, कि गरीबों के बारे में सोच रहे हैं, फिर आपने बोला कि नहीं वो पॉजिटिविस्ट क्यों, तो गरीबों के बारे में सोचना कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, इमैनुअल डर्खाइम भी सोच रहे हैं, बट आपने बोला कि सोशियोलॉजिस्ट को बायस नहीं होना, मतलब जो वो रिसर्च कर रहे हैं वो रिसर्च कर रहे हैं। तो अब मुझे बताओ कि कोई भी सोशियोलॉजिस्ट बायस कैसे होता है, बताओ।
तो
It was all about laborers and capitalists. There was no in between, no social aspect. No, I'm not asking this. I mean, my question is ke how sociologist becomes biased. This. Ananya. नहीं तो उसको वर्ड बताओ ना, तो नजरिए से कैसे देखते हैं बताओ, उस वर्ड को बताओ जो यूज किया गया है. आपको कॉन्सेप्ट्स के थ्रू बात करना है ना, अदरवाइज आप बड़ा जनरल आंसर लिख के आ जाओगे. आपको कोशिश करनी है. इट इज ऑल देयर इन योर हेड. वो वर्ड क्या है जिससे हम बायस्ड हो जाते हैं. एक हिंट देती हूँ, अब इसके बाद मैं हिंट दूंगी. लेट मी सी ऑनलाइन एस्पिरेंट्स. अगर आप लोगों को लगता है कि डॉक्टर हुमा हसन आप लोगों को खीर बना बना के ऐसे चम्मच में लो बेटा खा लो, वो नहीं करूंगी मैं. ठीक है, चाहे मुझे पूरा दोबारा से पढ़ाना पड़े वो मैं कर ही रही हूं. मैं टॉपिक 1 भी डिस्कस कर रही हूँ, टॉपिक 2 भी डिस्कस कर रही हूँ, टॉपिक 3 भी डिस्कस कर रही हूँ, राइट. अदरवाइज कार्ल मार्क्स में पहले पढ़ा चुकी हूँ, सारे थिंकर्स में पहले पढ़ा चुकी हूँ. तो मैं अभी ये पढ़ाने का काम क्यों कर रही हूँ, ताकि 3 महीने जो आप मेरे साथ सोशियोलॉजी पढ़ रहे हो, सोशियोलॉजी आपकी कंप्लीट हो जाए. वो तभी कंप्लीट होगी व्हेन यू पीपल आल्सो विल लाइक यू नो कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद योर फोकस एंड डिटर्मिनेशन. वरना नोट्स आपको हैंड रिटन नोट्स मिल गए हैं, बुक्स मिल गई है, PDF मिल गई है, एक्सप्लेनेशन भी दे दिया है. आपको खुद से मेहनत करने की कोशिश करनी पड़ेगी. एनीवे, फ्रॉम आउटसाइड डिसिप्लिन मैं सिर्फ आपसे ये क्वेश्चन पूछ रही हूँ, बायसनेस कैसे इंसान के दिमाग में आती है. आई हैव yesterday एक्सप्लेन ऑल दिस. मैंने कहा है ना आप लोगों से ये प्रोसेस है. हाँ, सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशंस नहीं, हाउ वंस बिकम बायस्ड. ऑफकोर्स सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशन कैन बी अ पार्ट. यू कैन सी योर नोट्स. मैंने आप लोगों को बोला है ना, जब कोर्स स्टार्ट होता है सबके अंदर बड़ा एंथुसियाज्म होता है, क्लास भरी रहती है. उसके बाद धीरे धीरे एंथुसियाज्म खत्म होता है, सर्दी लगने लगती है, इंटरेस्ट खत्म हो जाता है. इसीलिए बोलते हैं कंसिस्टेंसी. ओके, नाउ आई एम गिविंग यू हिंट. मैक्स वेबर ने क्या बोला है, किस तरीके से आप बायसनेस अपने रिसर्च में खत्म कर सकते हो. व्हाट आर द कॉन्सेप्ट गिवन बाय मैक्स वेबर, बताओ मुझे कॉन्सेप्ट बताओ एवरीवन. मैक्स वेबर ने क्या कहा है कि सोशल साइंस रिसर्च कैसी होनी चाहिए. हाँ, कल पढ़ाया है ना. वैल्यू न्यूट्रल. हम बायस कैसे होते हैं, वैल्यूज. ठीक है, तो जब अगर आप पॉवर्टी के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं कि वो पुअर्स के लिए मतलब उनके बाद बहुत इमोशंस था, तो वो वैल्यूज है ना. वैल्यूज कम्स आउट ऑफ आर ओन एक्सपीरियंसेस, हिस्ट्री एंड बायोग्राफी. चार्ल्स स्ट्रीट मिल्स, समझ में आ रहा है, चार्ल्स रिटमिल्स ने क्या कहा है. तो वैल्यूज, तो पॉजिटिविस्ट रिजेक्टेड कार्ल मार्क्स थ्योरी टू बी सोशियोलॉजिकल बिकॉज इट वॉज वैल्यू ड्रिवन. ओके, डू राइट डाउन दिस पॉइंट. तो पॉजिटिविस्ट, सो दिस इज क्लियर. ये आपके एक्सप्लेनेशन के लिए था बाय द वे. ओके, ये एक्सप्लेनेशन के लिए था. तो पॉजिटिविस्ट Positivist rejected Marxism due to its values. Positivist rejected Marxism due to its theory to be value driven. Positive rejected Marxism due to its theory to be value driven and not based and not and it was not based on scientific evidences. Okay, so other school of thoughts such as Max Weber, while other school of thought that is non-positivist who argues that it is difficult to have sociological theories as completely value free. It is difficult to have sociological theories as completely to be value free. So in this backdrop, Karl Marx is being considered as sociologist. In this, thus, in this backdrop, sociologist is being considered okay.
This question is by positivist in question Karl Marx is not a sociologist. Then we have to write to only this one, first we have to discuss about why he was, why, because the he is biased for the poor people and
no, you just have to say it was value driven. It is based on values, philosophies, okay, and he has not provided any facts like that, okay, like the positivist. Okay. So do write down few points here. After this, thus he theorized almost all his major theories. Thus, he theorized almost his major theories from the lenses of values, okay, as claimed by positivist. And others have rejected. It's like conclusion. Okay. So you aap usko likh do, it's like a conclusion. However, write down, however, Marx, Karl Marx influence, however, Karl Marx influence in Eastern Europe was overwhelming. While Western Europe where industrialization and capitalism flourished, got affected by the ideology of Karl Marx, which supported working class. Undoubtedly, Marx offered an abstract, coherent and greatly satisfying sociological theory that can be used to analyze any society, not just capitalist society, and their economic system. Okay. Anti-Marxian argues Marxian argues, anti-Marxian argues that Marxist theory is full of ideology. Marxist theory is full of ideology. Nevertheless, all sociological theories are based on some sort of ideologies. To conclude, Marx was humanist. So as Gandhiji was also humanist, so Karl Marx was a humanist who was deeply affected by the suffering and exploitation of working class in the new mode of production, that is capitalism. This eventually led him to propagate revolution. Okay. Revolution that would overturn the economic system, and brings social cohesion in society. Social cohesion and change in society. Karl Marx did not believe that revolution had to be bloody. So he was against bloodshed. Karl Marx did not believe that the revolution had to be bloody. BLOODY, bloody. He simply wanted a peaceful transition from capitalism to socialism. Is this clear now? Does anyone have any doubts? Now we need to understand about mode of production first of all. Then I will explain dialectic materialism. Please write down. Is this clear? Okay, now tell me what is mode of production? Tell me guys, what is mode of production? Yeah? Can anyone tell me mode of production? Please write down in the chat section, what is mode of production? I will explain definitely, but I want to know whether you people are going to tell me or not. What is mode of production? Think about it. What is mode of production? What words are here involved? Guys, this is not going to be. Tell me what is mode of production. Production which is necessary for life. Okay. That is, I'll take it. Tools, techniques, skills. Okay. First of all, we need to have a clarity on mode of production. Okay. All right. Now, whatsoever I have made all of you to understand, it is there in your PPT. Okay. So what you people have to do, can you all see the red line introduction? So now when you are going to make your notes, try to add up this thing which I have made you, I have explained. Now write down about all this point in your notes. For example, Karl Marx, what he has said. Okay, so in some sectors of the world, at least until the end of the Cold War, sociological theory was virtually identical Marxian and neo-Marxian theory. In Eastern Europe, Marx's influence was overwhelming, okay? But in Western Europe, Marx's influence has been highly variable. It was changed, okay? So Marx has had a profound positive influence. Others have fashioned their sociological theory, especially against Marxian theory, okay? So you can see what Marx had done. So Marx offered an abstract, coherent, and greatly satisfying sociological theory that can be used to analyze any society, not just capitalist society, okay? But still, we have, like, you know, debate whether he was a sociologist or not. Okay? So you need to go through this point. So I have explained whether he was a sociologist or not, and then you have a content too. So you need to go through all this point, all right? Which I'm not going to read in a class. I'm not going to read PPTs in a class. It is there for you to make your notes. Handwritten notes aapko mil chuke hain, aapko books mil chuki hai, ye jo PDFs hain, in PDFs ko aapko simple read karna hai. Read karke apne language mein likhna hai. Agar aap log apne language mein nahi likh paoge, to aapko fir clarity zyada nahi hogi. Okay? To ab was Marx a sociologist? Yahan pe sab maine jo explain kiya hai, likha hua hai. Okay, so ye aap logo ko pata karna chahiye. So how it was, why? So same points which I have said and explained in class, this is what it is. Okay, so go through all these points and read in your point, in your language. So in this view, Marx defies simple categorization. He was also a philosopher, revolutionary, pamphleteer, journalist, political scientist, Dalecians, and so on. So Marx is a highly complex thinker whose works are attractive to people in wide range of endeavors. But among the many labels fit Marx of sociologist. Okay. So now early and late Marxian theory. So there are many number of schools. We have neo-Marxian theory. So, postmodernism mein hum isko samjhenge. Are these mode of production by Marx? I'll explain, Prerna. Okay, when I'm going to discuss about mode of production, I'll explain that. Okay, so as Paul Thomas, we have today a galaxy of different Marxism and all. So, you need to read this, because when you are going to read, only I'm saying to read. Of course, where there's highlighted points, you need to see them. You need to make them in your notes, but then you need to have a good understanding. So why Marxism is very debatable, you know, question. even today. What Marx had said. So there are a lot of confusions and wrong interpretation for Karl Marx. For example, it is being said that Karl Marx was against capitalist mode of production. He had a issue with exploitation which was coming out of capitalism. In fact, he supported. So I'm telling you, Prerna, that I will explain all this. It is there. It is a part of mode of production. But I'll explain. Okay. So what you have to... Don't be sorry. It's just like I'll explain everything. So first of all, I'll need to tell you. I have already explained everything. Right? Slavery, primitive communism, then what is communism and all. But now we have to read in a deeper manner. Okay? So it is the way... अब जिसने पढ़ रखा है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्रेरणा, यू हैव स्टडीड, ओके, यू आर मेकिंग योर नोट्स, यू आर क्वाइट सेंसिबल, क्वाइट सिंसियर, सो डेफिनेटली यू कैन मेक द कोरिलेशन. अब आप लोगों को सोना है तो आप लोग सोते रहो, दूसरों को एस्पिरेंट्स को कह रही हो, आपको अगर माइंड करना है तो अच्छी बात है, माइंड करो, ठीक है, ताकि आप लोगों को समझ में आए. ये ग्रेजुएशन नहीं है सोशियोलॉजी या कोई मास्टर्स का प्रोग्राम नहीं है, आप यूपीएससी के लिए अप्लाई कर रहे हो. तो जिसने पढ़ा होगा वो ऐसे ही लिखेगा जैसे आप कर रहे हो प्रेरणा, यू नो. सो अगर एमर्जेंस ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी, यू नो द वे आई हैव टॉट, उसमें मैंने सारे थिंकर्स कवर अप करा दिए हैं, उसके बाद भी आप लोगों को सही में यू शुड फील अशेम ऑन योर सेल्फ. आई एम नॉट सेइंग टू यू तुमने थोड़ा लेट ज्वाइन किया है, ठीक है, तुमको मैं बोल रही हूं और जितने हैं, ओके, अगर आप लोगों को मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन समझ में नहीं आ रहा, फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्रेरणा, इट्स गुड यू हैव सेड, अदर एस्पिरेंट्स आल्सो हैव सेड इन ऑनलाइन एस्पिरेंट्स, आप लोगों से सही में ऑनलाइन एस्पिरेंट्स ज्यादा आंसर करते हैं, आप लोगों को ठंड लगने लगेगी, बीमार पड़ जाओगे, सुबह उठ के मेरा भी मन नहीं कर रहा होता आने के लिए, यू नो आई वोक अप एट 4. इंसान हम भी हैं, लेकिन अगर एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ली है कि यूपीएससी के बच्चों को पढ़ा रहे हैं तो वो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी मेंटेन करनी पड़ेगी ना, सैलरी को तो जस्टिफाई करना पड़ेगा ना. आप लोगों को जस्टिफिकेशन ही नहीं है अपनी, अपना आपने सोच लिया है कोई डॉक्टर हुमा हसन है वही बना देगी सोशियोलॉजिस्ट, वही सोशियोलॉजी कवर कर, तो करा रही हूं मैं, लेकिन आप लोगों को मैं स्पून फीडिंग नहीं करवा सकती हूं. मतलब आई फील वेरी एग्रेसिव, यू नो, आई फील बैड अबाउट इट व्हेन आई सी दैट यू पीपल आर नॉट रिप्लाइंग द आंसर पढ़ाने के बाद. वो सिर्फ ये शो करता है कि आप लोग नॉन सीरियस हो, क्योंकि अगर क्लास में आके 3 घंटे सुन रहे हो, आई एम टीचिंग इन इंग्लिश, आई एम टीचिंग इन हिंदी, दोनों तरीके के लैंग्वेज यूज कर रहे हैं, बायलैंग्वेज लैंग्वेज, ओके, और उसके बाद अगर आप सिर्फ मुझे बताओगे कार्ल मार्क्स का पर्सपेक्टिव कॉन्फ्लिक्ट है, तो फिर क्या फायदा हुआ है इमर्जेंस ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी को इतना इलैबोरेट करने के बाद, सुनाने के बाद. मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन में कॉमन सेंस यूज करो. कुछ एस्पिरेंट्स ने कॉमन सेंस के थ्रू ही आंसर बताया है. आई थिंक अभिषेक गौतम, हु हैड गिवन दिस लेबर एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट आंसर, टूल्स, टेक्निक्स एंड ऑल. ओके, सो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट गाइस, एटलीस्ट आप लोग मेहनत करो, फिजिकली प्रेजेंट मत रहो, चाहे ऑनलाइन क्लास में आ रहे हो चाहे ऑफलाइन क्लास में आ रहे हो, माइंड से प्रेजेंट रहो. ओके, सो जितने भी एस्पिरेंट्स इस एग्जाम को क्रैक करते हैं, टॉप रैंक्स में आते हैं, वो आसमान से नहीं उतरे हैं. ओके, उनको टाइम निकालना पड़ता है किस चीज के लिए, पता है आपको? बताओ, कैन एनीवन टेल मी दैट दोज हु आर पैशनेट, आई एम नॉट ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स, एनीवन हु इज पैशनेट, कौन से काम के लिए? एग्जैक्टली, राइट, तबीयत सबकी खराब होती है, फन सबको करना है, हम ह्यूमंस क्या है, खा लिया पी लिया सो जाओ, जानवरों से तो इवॉल्व हुए हैं हम, लेकिन अब हम सिविलाइज्ड हैं. नाउ वी आर सिविलाइज्ड, वी हैव सोसाइटीज, वी हैव गॉट सोसाइटीज. हाउ? बिकॉज वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस थिंग, राइट? तो आप लोगों को मेहनत करने की जरूरत है, पैशनेट होने की जरूरत है. पैशन नहीं है तो कुछ नहीं हो पाएगा लाइफ में. अगर पैशन होगा, आप लोगों को आई थिंक कितने टाइम हो गया, 2 वीक से तो आप लोग देख रहे होंगे मेरी वॉइस खराब है, ठीक है? लेकिन आई एम ऑल्सो टेकिंग द क्लासेस. इट्स नॉट दैट ये मेरा काम है, इट्स नॉट डेफिनेटली बिकॉज आई एम गेटिंग सैलरी, वो एक पार्ट है, लेकिन पैशन अलग दिखता है. ओके, सो हाउ यू मस्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट. आईएएस ऑफिसर बनने से पहले देश को अगर बदलना चाहते हो, अगर देश को बदलने की नियत से यूपीएससी कर रहे हो, तो जरूर ये क्रैक होगा. अगर लार्जर गोल्स हैं, मैक्रो गोल्स हैं, ओके, तो आपको कार्ल मार्क्स बनने के लिए कोई नहीं रोक सकता. कार्ल मार्क्स की सोच फिलोसफिकल थी, ह्यूमनिस्टिक थी. ह्यूमनिस्टिक थॉट क्या है? जहां पे आप लोगों के लिए सोचते हैं. गांधी की सोच क्या थी? ह्यूमनिस्टिक थी. अंबेडकर की सोच क्या है? ह्यूमनिस्टिक थी. जो भी लीडर्स हैं, जो भी चेंज लेके आते हैं, ओके, सो दे हैव वैल्यूज, सो यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली बिकम पैशनेट. ओके, वी ऑल आर मेड ऑफ फ्लैश एंड बोन्स, वी ऑल हैव डिजायर्स. गौतम बुद्ध बता के जा चुके हैं कि है डिजायर्स, लेकिन डिजायर्स को कंट्रोल करना सीखना होगा ना. वी ऑल आर इंडियंस, हमारी जो सभ्यता में है, हमारे तो जो गुरु है वो ही हमको पहले ही बता चुके हैं कि हमारी जीन्स में है. अगर आप हम इंडियन ट्रेडिशन देखो, जिसने पेपर 2 पढ़ा है मेरे से, तो एलेक्जेंडर, हु इज एलेक्जेंडर, पूरे देश को ऑक्यूपाई करने चला था ना, पूरे दुनिया को, इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट से वापस जाना पड़ा, वहीं पे मर भी गया आई थिंक, राइट? स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज व्हाट वी आर. इंडियंस आर पैशनेट, पैशनेट फॉर अदर्स. तभी अंग्रेज आए, दिल्ली सल्तनत के लोग आए, ठीक है, मुगल्स आए, आए रहे चले गए, लेकिन जो इंडियन ब्रीड्स हैं, जो हमारी इंडियन जीन्स हैं, दैट इज मेंट फॉर अदर्स, यू नो, टू सर्व सोसाइटी. तो एक लाइन यूपीएससी के बच्चे उन्हें ना रटी हुई है, दैट आई वॉन्ट टू कम इन टू यूपीएससी बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू सर्व द सोसाइटी. पहले आप अपने आप को तो चेंज करो, अपने आप को चेंज करो, फिट रहो. फिजिकली फिट रहोगे तो मेंटली फिट भी रहोगे. लेकिन आप लोग क्या कर रहे हो? मैकडोनाल्डाइजेशन. जो रिजर्ट ने ये बात बोली है, इट्स रिजर्व पोस्ट मॉडर्निस्ट, क्या कर रहे हैं? फास्ट फूड, सुबह उठ के फास्ट फूड खा रहे हैं. हमारे पास हाथ दिए हैं भगवान ने, रोटी दी है, अन्न दिया है, वो सब खाओ. फास्ट नहीं है हमारी जिंदगी. हमारे लिए हमारा सवेरा हो जाता है जब सूरज निकलता है. सूर्य को नमस्कार करने की है ना हमारी संस्कृति. क्या है हमारी संस्कृति? मैं सिर्फ हिंदूज की बात नहीं कर रही हूं, हिंदूज का नहीं है, सूरज सबके लिए. लेकिन हम जब उसको प्रणाम करते हैं, राइट, तो उसका मतलब क्या है? सो समवन से कि मैम तो मुसलमान है नहीं, आपको लग रहा हो कि मैम क्या बात कर रही है. सुबह उठ के द फर्स्ट नमाज विच वी ऑफर, इट्स लाइक यू नो इन द मॉर्निंग टाइम. तो जब सूरज निकल गया, उसके बाद मुस्लिम्स, इंडियन मुस्लिम्स या मुस्लिम्स ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, वो भी नमाज नहीं पढ़ सकते, वो नमाज खत्म हो जाती है फज्र नमाज का जो टाइम है. और वही हमारे लाइक यू नो और रिलीजन, उसमें क्या है, हिंदुइज्म क्या कहता है? सूर्य नमस्कार करो. उसको समझो कि क्यों करना है. इसमें डिवाइड मत हो जाओ कि हिंदूज ये कह रहे हैं, मुसलमान ये कह रहे हैं, सिख ये कह रहे हैं. फिलोसफी समझो. सुबह उठ के अगर हम सूरज के साथ अपनी स्पीड रखते हैं, नेचुरली साइंटिफिकली प्रूव भी है कि हम बहुत फिट रहते हैं, ठीक है. सूर्य गंगा में जाके सूर्य स्नान करते हैं हम लोग, ठीक है, सुबह जल्दी जाते हैं, राइट. तो क्या होता है उन सब चीजों से? आप फिट रहोगे, अच्छा खाओगे. हमको फास्ट फूड खाने की जरूरत नहीं है. पास्ता, बर्गर, छोड़ो ये सब. बीमार पड़ते रहोगे, सोशलाइजेशन के लिए पार्टीज क्लब्स ये नहीं है, ये नई चीजें आई है, ये एक आप समझो ये क्यों है ना, ये सक्सेसफुल हो पाया है, बहुत सालों से ये कोशिश हुई है कि इंडिया के स्पिरिचुअलिटी को खत्म कर दिया जाए, ट्रेडिशंस को खत्म कर दिया जाए, ना इंडियन ट्रेडिशंस खत्म होगी ना हो सकती है, ओके? ये हमारे संस्कार हैं जो अभी तक हम जुड़े हुए हैं, डाइवर्सिटीज, इंडियन डाइवर्सिटीज है ना, ओके? आई एम मुस्लिम राइट, बट आई कैन नॉट फील सेफ इन एनी अदर कंट्रीज, मुझे आप कहीं भी मुझे बोलो मुझे कहीं सेफ नहीं होता, फील सेफ नहीं होता, सो व्हाई? ये तो कुछ पॉलिटिशियंस का काम है जो हिंदू मुस्लिम्स को सिख ईसाई को लड़ा देते हैं, लेकिन अगर आप देखो सो वी ऑल आर ह्यूमन एंड वी नो अबाउट स्पिरिचुअलिटी, ओके? सो ह्यूमनिस्ट जो होगा वो ही ये एग्जाम भी क्रैक करेगा, मैं अगर आपको स्पेसिफिक गोल ओरिएंटेड बात करवाऊं तो, ठीक है? तो अगर आपकी डिसिप्लिन अच्छे हैं, जैसे मैंने आपसे पहले स्टार्ट करा था हैबिट्स को लेके, उसमें आपको कुछ नहीं करना, जो भी आप जिस भी रिलीजन को फॉलो करते हैं, हिंदू हो मुसलमान हो जो भी हो, बस रिलीजन की फिलॉसफी को समझो, ओके? अगर आप हाथ जोड़ देते हो, आप हाथ ऐसे कर लेते हो, वायुगुरु कह लेते हो, तो हम सब एक ही लाइट को यूज कर रहे हैं, नहीं भी कर, अगर किसी को गॉड में आस्था ही नहीं है, लेकिन फिर आप अच्छे तो बनो ह्यूमनिस्टिक, सबसे पहला रिलीजन क्या होना चाहिए, कोशिश क्या होनी चाहिए आप लोगों के लिए कि किसी और के दर्द से आपको भी दर्द हो, ओके? तो अपने आप फिलोसोफर बन जाते हैं, तो अगर आईएएस में बनना चाहते हो तो जो भी आपके थॉट प्रोसेस रहे होंगे कि गाड़ी मिलेगी, पैसा मिलेगा, फेम मिलेगा, और आजकल तो यूट्यूब में आईएएस ऑफिसर्स को ज्यादा लोग देखने लगे हैं क्योंकि वो ज्यादा अपने आप को, आई मीन दिस इज रॉन्ग राइट, आप रैंक वन लेके आओ, रैंक टू लेके आओ, कुछ भी लेके आओ, अपने आप को हाइप मत करो, आप लोग भी जब आईएएस ऑफिसर्स बन जाओ हाइप मत करो, आप लोगों को हाइप नहीं करनी है अपनी चीजें, आप बताओ, कम इन सेमिनार्स, टॉक इन सेमिनार्स, आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है देश को संभालना, तो आप कुछ नया नहीं कर रहे हैं, गाड़ी से उतर के आप गए यहाँ पे, दिस टॉपर हैड कम, दिस टॉपर इज डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग, पॉपुलर होने के लिए फिर मीडिया है ना, आप जाओ हीरो हीरोइन बनो, ठीक है? अब खैर आई एम नॉट सेइंग एनीथिंग कि वो डेलिबरेट है कि क्या है, ओके? लोग भी इट्स इंडस्ट्री को, एक कोचिंग इंडस्ट्री चल रही है बहुत बड़ी, आई एम ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ इट, तो हो सकता है इसलिए भी करते हो, बट लेट्स जस्ट कम आउट ऑफ इट, ठीक है? प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड कार्ल मार्क्स इन अ वे जो आपको जिंदगी भर याद रहे, ठीक है? सो अभी ये समझ में आया है, लेट जस्ट कम बैक टू आवर सिलेबस, ही इज ह्यूमनिस्ट, ह्यूमनिस्ट मीन्स दैट कीपिंग द वैल्यूज इंटैक्ट, दैट्स इट, ऑलराइट? व्हिच इज सोशियोलॉजी इज नॉट सेइंग, पॉजिटिविस्ट, ओके? पॉजिटिविस्ट सोशियोलॉजी इज सेइंग दैट वी शुड नॉट हैव सच पॉइंट्स, ऑलराइट? सो लेट मी जस्ट टेल यू ऑल दिस पीपीटी, आपको क्या करना है यहां से समझना है, ऑलराइट? सो बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म वी मस्ट नो मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, व्हाट इज मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, एज पीपल हैव टोल्ड मी अबाउट दिस, mode of production is what in which we are producing, okay? In which we are producing, this is mode of production, producing what? Producing necessities of our life, okay? So mode of production is very important for us, because if we can understand mode of production, we are going to understand historical materialism. Okay, we are going to understand commodification. All right, objectification or commodification is the same thing. Then we will understand relation of production. Then we are going to understand class struggle. Then alienation. Okay. So write down for the mode of production a definition. Mode of production, everything that goes into the production, of the necessities of life okay, comma, including the productive force, forces, including the productive forces, labor, comma, instrument, raw material, the relation of production, comma, the relation of production, then write down in a that is brackets, the social structure. That regulate the relation, that regulate the relation between humans in the production of goods. According to Karl Marx and Engels and Frederick Engels, E-N-G-E-L, according to Marx and Engels, for individuals, the mode of production is the definite forms of expressing their life on their part. Okay. So now this mode of production is why this is important. Let's just read what is mode of production quickly, okay, for our understanding. So this mode of production has two important parts, that is means of production what it is like infrastructure, tools, techniques, machines, okay, So these are the means of production. These means of production will tell us social structure, that is relation of production. So what is your relation of production? Relation of production is like your control on means of production. That is, you can say, a relation of production. And this control is determined by your position in society. What is your position in the relation of production? So what is your position in the relation of production? Okay. To explain this means of production. Now is this clear? So means of production, equipments, tools, techniques. Okay. And then your position in the relation of production will tell the social structure of society. So the position in the relation of production will decide social structure in society. Okay. So what it is? According to Karl Marx, when he is explaining historical materialism, okay, please listen to me here. Okay. Keep writing. So when he is explaining, he says that he is evolutionary. Who are evolutionary? Who believes that society moves from one stage to another stage. Okay. So keep writing this point now. So Karl Marx is evolutionary. So who are evolutionary? Who believes society evolves from one stage to another? To see this evolution, he focuses on economic relation. He focus on means of production and relation in the means of production. He developed a tool that is historical materialism. Which is, you will see, dialectical materialism. Historical materialism and dialectical materialism. Dialectical materialism is a relationship, okay? So this is what he has done. So historical materialism and dialectical materialism. Okay? So he is evolutionary who believes society always changes. So he says that primitive society which is a stone age. So here in the primitive society, so what is mode of production? Hunting and gathering. hunting and gathering, right? In hunting and gathering, there is no position of materialistic thing. There is no positions of materialistic things. So no position, no means of production were there. So we used to eat, we used to hunt, and we used to eat. So there was no position. So in the primitive society, means of production were hunting and gathering, and there was no positions. There was no private property, no positions, no private property. Okay, so what type of social structure we have? So now the social structure in primitive society is egalitarian, equal. It's equal, equality. Okay, so there was no class. Okay, there is no class. Okay, understand? Now we are going to see the second stage. What is second stage, Prerna? Agriculture. Asiatic society. Yes, it's slavery. Okay. So, first of all, we did have what? We did have positions, right? So now we are going to see, so this is our primitive society, and in primitive society means of production was hunting and gathering. So there was no positions, so there was no materialistic things to hold, so there was no private property. Hunting and gathering society, and you can say pastoralist society, horticulturalist society too, right? So transition phase, all right? So in pastoralist and also in hunting and that horticultural society, we did have positions. So in primitive society, we did not have positions. But then in the second stage, so what is the second stage? After hunting and gathering, and this is for your explanation, okay? So after hunting and gatherer, we become pastoralist. Pastoralist and horticulturalist. Where first time people were doing something else without hunting. Okay, so position got start. Division of labor got started. The very first time in the history of mankind, people were doing something else without, you know, besides hunting. So some group were raising animals, or some started cultivating food. Shifting cultivation got starting at this position, at this stage only. Okay, but still there was no class. Position got started, but still there was no class. Is this clear? Okay, position was started, but no class still. No notion of equality and, you know, were like that. Then we have got, this is what we have said. Now we have got into the second stage. Second stage is Asiatic society. Okay, Asiatic society. Their means of production is what? Tell me. Their means of production was agriculture. Okay, so now we have it's a cultivation. So you can say it become agriculture. So system was agriculture, but in means of production, what was means? There was no machines. Okay, so there was no machines. It was based on human labor. Okay, so those who got maximum control over human labor those who have got maximum control of human labor were dominant. So what you can see here, what we have seen, right? So there was no position here. So here we have got position. So what is the position? It's human labor. So what is the position, guys? Humans. Human labor. Okay. So here, now we will see what type of social structure we have. So it's economical structure which will decide social structure. So what type of social structure we have? We have now got two classes. Okay. And Karl Marx have spoke about these two classes only throughout his historical materialism. Have and have not. So have and have not. So here it is about who have and have not, about human labor. Okay, so those who have control over human labor, they come to known as master. Those who were selling themselves okay, they were selling themselves completely, they belonged to slaves. Samajh mein aaya? This is historical materialism basically. Now, what we can see here, in the primitive society, means of production was hunting and gathering. No position, no materialistic thing, no private property. Then social structure was egalitarian, equality, no class. And this society is being known as primitive communism according to Karl Marx, communism, primitive socialism, socialism and communism both. Okay, then in Asiatic society, so the food, how we are obtaining food? By agricultural. Okay, no, it's not lords and serfs, it will come later on. All right, so it's like no machines, human labor, and there were only two classes. So human labor is being sold out, and here how to maintain, so those who had a maximum number of humans who are working for him, they are become masters, and now they enjoy dominant position. Okay, so they enjoy dominant position because they have number, maximum number of slaves. So because of their economical position, they have dominant position where they do have dominant position where, tell me, in politics and in social too. So on social, on political structure, on social structure, they are dominant. They become dominant. So they are the most powerful. Okay? Now in the third society, so the third society is a society of feudal society. Feudal society, so now it's a feudal society. Okay, now what is the means of production here? What? No, in feudal society it was also agricultural, advanced agricultural. Okay, so it's advanced agriculture basically. Okay, and here in the means of production, you will see what is happening. Private property, like, you know, becomes systematic. So private property, you can say it was here also. Here also, we did have private property ka concept. But yahan pe kya hua? In advanced level, now through rules and regulations, through monarch or king system, territories, okay, territorial expedition and everything. Now we got some sort of paperwork to have exploitation. So now the slavery was not there completely, but it was, it now the relationship is coming between feudal lord, zamindars and the peasants, serfs. Modern production is agriculture, but now it's become systematic. So rules and regulations is there, it's systematic. So earlier also it was a private property and it was a operation. Yahan pe operation or exploitation start ho gaya tha. Operation and exploitation start ho gaya tha. Yahan pe bhi operation and exploitation of one class got started. So kaun si two classes thi yahan pe? Feudal. Feudal lords and peasants or serfs. Ab yahan pe bhi they are giving their labor, bonded labor. So these were bonded laborers, right? Slavery sort of, now bonded labor. यहां पे भी ह्यूमन लेबर ही है, Because now rules and regulation, monarch, king, territorial expedition. So exploitation is happening by some sort of paperwork. Okay? Now, in the third society, so what you can see here? You can see here, we have got two classes, feudal lords, we have got peasants and serfs. Exploitation is also happening, but now it's become systematic. So, yahan pe now, paperwork is there, which is telling us about private property. Okay, then here we are now in the 18th-19th century. So it is what is happening? Tell me, it is now industrial society. And mode of production is? Tell me. Mode of production is machinery. So here, क्या था हमारा स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज थी तो मशीनरी इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन ओके नाउ इट्स अ मॉडर्न वे ऑफ एक्सप्लॉयटेशन मॉडर्न वेज ऑफ लाइफ Where again human labor is there, but now it is being what we are getting wages. Yes, okay. So, this means of production is giving us which type of social structure? It is giving us social structure, which type of where we have capitalist and workers. So now we still have wages, exploitation. And then we do have two classes. So this capitalists are now enjoying high political and social positions too, which is coming out of economics, right? In the fifth society, which is he believed to be a communist society, right? He believes actually it's a socialist society where there was no class. There will be, you know, large scale of production. There will be capitalism but no ownership. Okay, so according to the needs of group, according to the needs of an individual, there will be a distribution of wealth. So, you can say no concentration of wealth. Done. Is this clear? Anyone who has got doubts? Anyone who has got doubt, because this is very important to understand the base of Karl Marx. After this, everything will be easy. Okay, so we can take 10 minutes ka break and then I will just complete. So before going on break, let me just tell you a few things. Just wait. We are going to have a discussion on historical materialism in the dialectic. But in this, we are going to focus on mode of production, which I have just explained. Okay, so what is mode of production? I believe everyone is clear with. So now take a break for 10 minutes or so. एक्स्ट्रा क्लासेस रह गई है, मतलब कौन सी एक्स्ट्रा क्लासेस? तो आप लोगों को किसने कहा है ऑप्शनल और जीएस की कोचिंग एक साथ रहने के लिए? ये इतना रॉन्ग अप्रोच है ना, इतना रॉन्ग अप्रोच है, आप लोग समझते नहीं हो, आप लोग बर्डन लेते हो अपने सर पे. यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल शुड ईदर टेक जीएस, जीएस कंप्लीट हो जाए इट्स देन टेक ऑप्शनल. इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन, इट्स जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ 1.5 years एंड मोर देन 1.5 years, एट लीस्ट 2 साल की प्रिपरेशन है. तो जब आप जीएस की भी प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो, ऑप्शंस भी ले रहे हो, तो आप लोग यू विल बी फ्लडेड विद लॉट ऑफ बर्डन. 2-3 घंटे की क्लास आपने यहाँ पे ली सोशियोलॉजी की फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर योर ऑप्शनल, उसके बाद 3-4 घंटे लगते हैं उसको एब्जॉर्ब करने के लिए. मैंने जब आपको पढ़ा दिया, फिर आप नोट मेकिंग नहीं कर रहे हो. ओके, ये बहुत ही रॉन्ग अप्रोच है. पता नहीं क्यों है यहाँ पे, क्यों ऐसे चला हुआ है ये. हम इंसान ही है ना, वी ऑल आर ह्यूमंस, सो वी कैनॉट टेक द बर्डन. डू यू नो दैट हाउ मच कैलोरीज गेट बर्न व्हेन वी रीड समथिंग? यू नो द काइंड ऑफ मेंटल यूज वी डू, इंटेलेक्चुअल, वी ऑल आर इंटेलेक्चुअल बीइंग, एंड व्हेन वी थिंक एंड व्हेन वी प्रोसेस, इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ फिजिकल, यू नो इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ कैलोरीज. तो जितना आप वो ईटे उठा के मेहनत करोगे ना, उतना आप 20-25 मिनट बैठ के जो सुन रहे हो उससे ज्यादा मेहनत लगती है. तभी मजदूरों को वेजेस मिलते हैं और जो इंजीनियर्स होते हैं नक्शे बनाने के लिए उनको ज्यादा पैसे मिलते हैं. तो आप लोगों की बहुत गलत अप्रोच है ये. ठीक है, पहले आप जीएस करो और जीएस को इस तरीके से करो जो आपको प्रीलिम्स और मेंस में दोनों में काम आए. फिर उसके बाद आप ऑप्शनल दो. और ऑप्शनल प्लीज गाइज डू नॉट सी हियर वेयर एनी वन वीडियोज एंड थिंक के हो जाएगा. कुछ एस्पिरेंट्स मेरे पास आते हैं टेस्ट सीरीज के लिए, ठीक है, क्योंकि मार्केटर्स का, एडवर्टाइजर का काम ही है सब कुछ फैंसी कर देना. ओके, तो कोई अभी जो आप लोग जैसे कुछ एस्पिरेंट्स होंगे जो जिनको लगता है कि उनको कार्ल मार्क्स समझना है, तो वो क्या सर्च करते हैं? 10 मिनट वाली वीडियो, 5 मिनट वाली वीडियो. 5 से 10 मिनट की वीडियो में आपको कार्ल मार्क्स समझ में आ जाएगा. कार्ल मार्क्स कितने टाइम हो गया मुझे पढ़ाते हुए, कोई ऐसी क्लास नहीं होगी जहां पे हमने थिंकर्स के बारे में बात नहीं करा, तब भी आपको डाउट्स हैं, राइट? कार्ल मार्क्स, सोशियोलॉजिस्ट, एनी थिंकर्स, एनी थिंग कैन नॉट हैपन इन वन गो. एंड नो आई मीन नॉट एवरी वन कैन टीच, देयर विल बी अ डिफरेंस. नेम समझ आएगा, थ्योरी नहीं. I agree with you, Gautam. नहीं, नाम के अलावा भी कुछ कुछ समझ में आ जाएगा कि लड़ाई है, दो क्लास है, एनिमेशन डाल देंगे बीच में. एक I was again amazed. अच्छा पार्ट है वो, हमारे यहाँ जेएनयू में भी हमको सिखाया गया था, पिक्चर्स के थ्रू सोशियोलॉजी पढ़ा रहा है कोई, पिक्चर्स के थ्रू, यू नो मूवीज, बॉलीवुड मूवीज के थ्रू सोशियोलॉजी पढ़ा रहे हैं. बॉलीवुड मूवीज के थ्रू हम लोगों ने भी पढ़ा है मीडिया, सोशल चेंज, एंड यू नो वी हैव आल्सो सीन. सो पहले ये कॉन्सेप्ट समझ गए तब हमने दिलीप कुमार की नया दौर पढ़ा किया था, वो भी मास रिसर्च के टाइम पे, मास्टर्स इन फिलोसफी, एमफिल जब कर रहे थे. सौदागर मूवी देखी है, कौन सी? सबसे पुरानी वाली अमिताभ बच्चन की, ठीक है. सोशल रिलेशनशिप यस इज बीइंग डिपिक्ट इन मूवीज. सोशियोलॉजी इज लिटरेचर प्रेरणा, डेफिनेटली इट्स लिटरेचर. अभी हम कार्ल मार्क्स को एज अ स्टोरी तो पढ़ रहे, उसके व्यू पॉइंट्स को पढ़ रहे. व्हाट इंग्लिश फिलोसोफर्स डू, व्हाट यू थिंक व्हाट फिलोसोफर्स आर डूइंग, दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सोसाइटी, दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट यू नो व्हाट गोज ऑन इन द माइंड. सो फॉर मी कार्ल मार्क्स इज अ फिलोसोफर, ही इज इंग्लिश फिलोसोफर, जहां से भी हो आप. दिस इज वॉट वी हैव टू लर्न, इंटरडिसिप्लिनरी अप्रोच. अब एल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन को आप सोशो, उसने इमेजिनेशन के बारे में लिखा है ना, आइंस्टाइन ने. वी हैव सोशियोलॉजिकल इमेजिनेशन. आइंस्टाइन सेज दैट इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू इमेजिन. अगर आप इमेजिनेशन नहीं कर सकते हैं तो आप थ्योरीज नहीं लिख सकते हैं. ओके, तो आई वुड जस्ट सिंपली से के अब ये वीडियोज हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मैं अभी 3 आवर्स में, मुझे लगता है कि कल का और क्लास लगेगा टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन अ डीपर मैनर. बट अगर आपने यहाँ पे मेहनत कर ली तो फिर आपको फिर नहीं सोचना पड़ेगा. अभी भी एस्पिरेंट्स के पास मेल आते रहते हैं जो फर्स्ट बैच के हैं कि मैम नोट मेकिंग नहीं हुई, इसको कैसे करना है, टेस्ट कैसे करना है. तो ये आप लोगों की बेवकूफी है, ठीक है. कोई भी कुछ भी कह दे, आपको खुद समझना है कि करना कैसी प्रिपरेशन है आपको. जल्दी में कुछ नहीं होता है. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इधर टेक ऑप्शनल्स और टेक जीएस. ऑप्शनल्स को भी जब प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो तो ऐसे प्रिपरेशन करो 300 प्लस आने चाहिए, और आते ही हैं. एस्पिरेंट्स के 300 प्लस आते हैं, ठीक है. तो इसके ऊपर अभी हम ज्यादा चर्चा नहीं करेंगे. अभी मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन समझ में आ गया, ठीक है. मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन में व्हाट वी हैव लर्न नाउ, वी हैव गॉट नाउ 2 क्लासेस, राइट. अब हमारे पास, अब वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस. क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस विल लीड अस टू क्लास स्ट्रगल. तो कार्ल मार्क्स इज सेइंग दैट देयर आर 2 क्लासेस इन सोसाइटी. Okay, and we have seen how. So through historical materialism, through the evolution of society, we have understood that how there are always 2 classes. And there are 2 classes on the basis of their economical position. According to their economical position, we decide whether they are dominant class or they are oppressive class. So, we should know that for Karl Marx, society, first of all, society has infrastructure. So we have plants, we have all this sun, moon, you know, pahar, ye sab hai. Then we have its economy, which is base structure. And this base structure will lead to political base and then social base. Okay? So, Karl Marx have a very famous line that every society will have class struggle will have class struggle. Okay? over resources, over economical resources. Okay. In order to explain this class struggle, we have dialectical materialism. Okay. So Marx borrow the concept of dialectic. From Friedrich Hegel. Okay. So let's see what Friedrich Hegel had done. So what is dialectic means? Dialectic means two ideas, according to Friedrich Hegel. Okay, he says that in every societies there will be a two ideas. So one idea will be dominant, and other idea will be, you can say it was less forceful. So it will be dominant, this idea will be forceful, it will be a popular, so it is popular, currently accepted, and this is less popular. Okay, so Friedrich Hegel gives his theory on the basis of philosophy. Okay, he talks about that in every society there is like thesis and synthesis, that I will explain. So Hegel says that there will be a thesis. For example, thesis is what tells us dominant idea which is accepted in society. Okay, so thesis here is what it will say, that this idea is good. We need to accept this idea for the welfare of society or everything. For example, thesis will say that religion should be, the whole idea to understand, I'm talking about 16th, 17th century, before 14th century. Okay, it said religion should be the guiding factor in one life. Religion should be the guiding factor. This is an idea. To this idea, we have antithesis. Which says, no, religion must not be guiding factor, but science should be. Okay, so there will be a conflict in these two. So when there will be a conflict, there will be a struggle, class struggle. So there will be one class who support. So there will be a one class who will support this. So one class will support religion. So religion, dogmatic people in 14th century, church. Okay. Let's just say example. Then we have another class who were scientists, philosophers, okay, who says no. Now there is a synthesis. So synthesis in 18th, 19th century according to Max Weber is, then there is a synthesis. So religion got modified and we have decided our economy on that, according to Max Weber wala. Okay, so there is a synthesis. So religion now has not that specific role, economy has that specific role. So something new had happened, okay, in which religion is also there in some part, and then there is a synthesis. Is this clear? These are ideas. Karl Marx says that we cannot deal only to understand dialectics from ideas. So he said that dialectics, basically this conflict between classes, this conflict between classes must originate from materialistic analysis. Okay? So he says that now in society they are capitalist. So they are dominant. Now we have workers who are being oppressed. So because they are being oppressed, so these are theses and these are antitheses. Now there will be a conflict between these two, right? And then we have got socialism. As new idea. ये मैंने explain कर रखा था आप लोगों को अच्छे से, ठीक है? Yes, it's thinking and imaginations of the world. Historical materialism is clear to everyone. Abhishek, Ananya, Chakravarti, Shubham. Is this clear to everyone? So this is basically you must know with respect to historical materialism. So when you are going to read from your book, PDF, so Marx adopted the dialectical mode of logic. So this is a mode of logic from Hegel. ठीक है? So this is dialectical mode of logic from Hegel. Hegel focused dialectic of ideas. Karl Marx focused on material world. And this was a transformation. It allowed Marx to move the dialectic out of the realm of philosophy. So earlier, these dialectics, these ideas, we were using only in philosophies. So this dialectics, this two relation class struggle, Karl Marx has used into the realm, that is social relation. So yahan se hum social relationship samajh rahe. Is this clear to everyone? Right? So it is the focus that makes Marx's work most relevant to sociology. So when you want to show that how Karl Marx's work is relevant, you need to tell like this. So dialectical approach is what? Dialectical approach is very different from the mode of thinking. Okay? And here the dialectical method of analysis does not see a simple one-way cause and effect relationship. For the dialectical thinkers, we try to understand social influences, right? Social influences never simply flow in one direction. So dialectics are what? Where we are trying to see the idea, social influences, and how it is bringing change. All right? So these are the dialecticals. So dialecticals kaun hote hain? Dialectics means two ideas. So they try to understand society from the realm of philosophy. Ki kya achhai hai, kya burai hai. Dialectics is like opposites. Okay, are you understanding? Dialectic matlab kya hota hai? Ideas. Philosophers jo hain, unhone hamesha samaj ko kaise samjha hai? Achha, bura, din, raat, bhagwan, shaitan. Okay, ideas, philosophies. तो फ्रेडरिक हीगल ने भी आइडियाज यूज करे थे और वो बता रहे थे दो आइडियाज है. तो पहले फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंडियन सोसाइटी को ले सकते हैं हम. वेदास वर द डोमिनेंट आइडिया, ठीक है. वेदास वर द डोमिनेंट आइडियाज एंड वी गॉट वेदिक फिलोसफीज, कास्ट सिस्टम वगैरह, रिचुअल्स. फिर जैनिज्म बुद्धिज्म आया इंडिया में. तो ब्राह्मण एक डोमिनेंस था ब्राह्मण्स का. तो ब्राह्मण्स का डोमिनेंस को चैलेंज बुद्धिज्म जैनिज्म ने किया कि प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच होनी चाहिए. फिर हमने न्यू वे ऑफ लाइफ देखी, राइट. तो अब कास्ट सिस्टम थोड़ा, वेदास थोड़ी अलग हो गई, सेक्युलर हो गई, ठीक है, और न्यू वेज ऑफ लाइफ आ गया, प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच आ गया. तो दोनों का एमिग्रेशन हो गया. ये डायलेक्टिक्स होते हैं. ओके, सो डायलेक्टिक्स, सो टू द डायलेक्शन वन फैक्टर, कुछ फैक्टर के वजह से कुछ इफेक्ट आया. ओके, यहां पे अब व्हाट यू आर सीइंग हियर, व्हाट कार्ल मार्क्स हैड डन, ही हैज ट्राइड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस एक्सप्लॉयटेशन बियॉन्ड दिस डायलेक्टिक्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द इंक्रीजिंग एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ द वर्कर्स और प्रोलेटेरियट बाय द कैपिटलिस्ट मे कॉज द वर्कर्स टू बिकम इंक्रीजिंगली डिसेटिस्फाइड. समझ में आ गया? वर्कर्स जो है वो डिसेटिस्फाइड हो रहे हैं अपनी लाइफ से. बट द इंक्रीजिंग मिलिटेंसी ऑफ द प्रोलेटेरियट मेड विल, नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, वर्कर्स जो है वो डिसेटिस्फाइड हो रहे हैं. ओके, एंड मोर मिलिटेंट. बट द इंक्रीजिंग मिलिटेंसी ऑफ द प्रोलेटेरियट माइट वेल कॉज द कैपिटलिस्ट टू रिएक्ट by becoming even more exploitative in order to crush the resistance of the workers. So dialectics ka kya kaam hota hai? Alag alag nazariye se dekhna, theek hai. Ab yahan pe aap dekho dialectic ki thinking kya hai. The increasing exploitation of the proletariat by capitalists may cause the workers to become increasingly dissatisfied. अब जो रेवोल्यूशन लेके आएंगे वो डिसेटिस्फाइड हो रहे हैं वर्कर्स. वो कह रहे हैं कि बहुत ही, क्योंकि एक्सप्लॉयटेशन किया जा रहा है. अब मैं यहाँ पे डिसेटिस्फाइड हो रही हूं, मुझको क्रश करने के लिए क्या हो सकता है? सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, आई हैव बिकम डिसेटिस्फाइड एंड मोर मिलिटेंट I'm becoming rebellious. Now I want to create revolution against this hegemony. So, but the increasing militancy of the proletariat might well cause the capitalist to react. So, agar ab main system ke against ja rahi hu, okay? Capitalist ke against ja rahi hu, to capitalist kya karenge? Wo apna aur force use karenge so that is revolution ko suppress kar de. So, what is happening? We are trying to understand society from different perspectives. So, a workers is becoming rebellious. So, workers is showing their resistance to the capitalism. In reaction, capitalist kya kar rahe hain? Wo aur violent ho rahe hain. Okay? Samajh mein aa gaya? So, this kind of thinking does not mean the dialectician never consider casual relationship in the social world. It does mean that when dialectical thinkers talk about cause and effects padha tha na bhi? Cause and effect, they are always attuned to reciprocal relationship. Okay? So, in dialectical analysis, especially as Marx developed, social values are not separate from social facts. This is important. So, he says that social values are not different from social facts. Okay? So, facts kahan se aa rahi hai? Wo values se hi aa rahi hai. So, ab yahan pe hamara class consciousness develop ho gaya. Kaise class consciousness develop ho gaya? So, if I belong to worker class, I will have certain sort of identity with working class. Or if I'm capitalist, I will have a certain sort of consciousness with capitalist class. Okay? Samajh mein aa gaya, guys? Dialectic materialism, kisi ko doubt hai? So this is what you all can see. So for Marx, what is the classes? There are two major classes within capitalist society. Bourgeoisie, that is capitalist, and the proletariat, that is workers. So the bourgeoisie is defined by the fact. Dekho inhone kya use kare. The bourgeoisie is defined by the fact that it owns the means of production, factories, tools, and so on. And the proletariat by the fact that it must sell its labor time to the bourgeoisie in order to earn wage that allows it to survive. Clear? This is class consciousness. So in Das Kapital, in his book, in Capital, Marx talk about the capitalist as werewolves and vampires who suck the blood out of the workers, and he was very sympathetic to the plight of the proletariat. Plight matlab bad conditions. So Marx was emotional involvement in it. He was studying did not mean that his observation was inaccurate. So just saying that he was emotionally involved, but it does not mean that his studies was inaccurate. Okay? Is this clear? So, in fact, research into the work of scientists indicates that the idea of dispassionate scientist. So, yahan pe ab isko aap sirf read kar lenge, okay? So, this you people need to read all these points, okay? So, historical materialism, please write down the dialectics. You must make notes on historical materialism for 250 words. These pages you should just read once, okay? So this is here the dialectic thesis, antithesis, synthesis. Okay, are you understanding this point? So aapko ek bari isko padhna padega. and I would be providing you notes on historical materialism, okay, more that how you should write down, but these are more than enough for you to read. But kis tarike se ek specified notes banne chahiye, that I will give you historical materialism and all that, okay. So the dialectician is interested in the study of real relationship rather than grand abstraction, but in the real world there are two. So yahan se aapko ye points yahan se mil jayenge. Then you need to have a notes on class conflict. Okay, so there is a conflict between the capitalist and the proletariat, and although he foresaw a revolution and ultimate, so this is what class conflict. So they are having a conflict because of what? Because of resources. Okay, so different needs. So conflict and contradiction from page number 50 you will see. So dialectic is it concerned with conflict and contradiction. So what is dialectical materialism? You can see it from here. So conflict and contradictions, okay, and this contradiction brings a change, the process of change, which we have seen at synthesis. Samajh mein aa raha hai ki nahi? Theek hai, koi confusion to nahi hai? All right. So conflict and contradiction, it's like here. So dialectic leads to an interest in the conflicts and contradiction among various levels of social reality. So we try to understand that what type of relationship we have and how it is bringing social change. That is what we are going to do. So this is all the points which is red in color. You should see the conflict between the large scale structure created by capitalists and the interest of the proletariat. Ultimate contradiction within capitalism for Marx exists in the relationship between the bourgeoisie and the proletariat. Okay, so the bourgeoisie produces the proletariat and producing and expanding the class. Capitalists are producing their own game trigger. So what you have to understand, see, there are two different interests for two different classes. Capitalist ka interest hai profit. Keep writing all this point. So capitalist का इंटरेस्ट है प्रॉफिट, प्रोलेटेरियट का इंटरेस्ट है कि उनके साथ एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ना हो, राइट? बट दीज टू क्लासेस आर गोइंग टू बी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑलवेज. अल्टीमेटली कार्ल मार्क्स इज सेइंग दैट इफ वी टॉक अबाउट क्लास स्ट्रगल, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ स्ट्रगल बिटवीन हैव एंड हैव नॉट. Okay, so he says that in order where exploitation is increasing by whom? By capitalist, it will further create lot of resistance, and eventually they are having their own grave, they are digging their own grave, because workers, there will be a time where workers will stop taking this exploitation, they will become more stronger. And then they will do what? They are going to go against this exploitation, and they will have a revolution. So Karl Marx is saying that then there will be a revolution, and in this revolution, what will happen? They are going to overthrow the power of capitalism or capitalist. So there will be a class struggle. So how revolution is happening? Revolution is happening, protest is happening, unions वगैरह बनते हैं, associations बनते हैं, और फिर capitalist को हम हटा देंगे. This is a class struggle. हाँ, क्योंकि revolution नहीं हुई ना. Weber यही तो बोल रहे हैं कि जो Karl Marx ने कहा कि revolution से होगा और capitalist चले जाएंगे, ऐसा नहीं हुआ. हाँ, तो इसीलिए जब हम conflict को या class को समझेंगे, हम मल्टी डायमेंशन अप्रोच समझेंगे. कार्ल मार्क्स वाज बीइंग क्रिटिसाइज्ड बिकॉज़ ही हैड यूज्ड ओनली टू क्लासेस, बट वी नो दैट देयर आर मल्टीपल क्लासेस, वी हैव मिडिल क्लासेस, कॉर्पोरेशन एंड ऑल दैट, दैट इज गिवन टू अस बाय मैक्स वेबर. ऑलराइट, तो आप लोगों को क्या करना है? हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म 250 वर्ड्स का आंसर, क्लास स्ट्रगल, मोड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, राइट? ये सारा इंटर रिलेटेड है, कुछ भी इसमें अलग सा नहीं है. लेकिन अगर हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म में आया तो आपको फोकस करना है हिस्टोरिकल मटेरियलिज्म में. क्लास स्ट्रगल में आया तो यू नीड टू फोकस ऑन द क्लास स्ट्रगल. ओके, तो ये जो पीपीटीज है इट विल गिव यू मोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, सो रेजिस्टेंस बिगेट्स मोर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन एंड ऑपरेशन एंड द लाइकली रिजल्ट इज अ कन्फ्रंटेशन बिटवीन द टू क्लासेस. ओके, सो रेजिस्टेंस बिगेट्स, रेजिस्टेंस क्या होगा, बहुत एक्सप्लॉयटेशन और ऑपरेशन कैपिटलिस्ट क्लास करने लगेगी और इसमें क्या होगा, देयर विल बी अ टाइम वेयर देयर विल बी अ व्हाट, देयर विल बी अ रेवोल्यूशन. ओके, so you all have to go through all this once. Okay guys, are you people understanding? So it says that in the end there will be a what, there will be some points in which you are going to understand about revolution. Then here you can see about human potential. All right, so let me just give you some writing on historical materialism and all. Okay, yeah, so I'm saying that now what you will get, you will get handwritten notes again, theek hai, on the basis of this PPT. theek hai, aapko mail aa jayega. So in this mail, on this mail you should see about historical materialism. I think historical materialism samajh mein aa gaya aap logo ko, theek hai, class struggle, okay, and you will have notes on this thing, alienation and human potential and all. Okay, so just you need to go through these PDFs. ये जो PDFs है इसको आप लोगों को पढ़ना बहुत जरूरी है. ठीक है, आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ह्यूमन पोटेंशियल व्हाट ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट. ओके, ऑलराइट, सो वी आर गोइंग टू हैव डिस्कशन ऑन व्हाट इज पावर्स एंड नीड्स एंड ऑल दैट दैट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग. ओके, तो आप लोगों को क्या करना है, सिर्फ इसको पढ़ना है. ऑलराइट, व्हाट ह्यूमन पोटेंशियल ही हैज टॉक अबाउट, व्हाट पावर एंड नीड्स ही हैज स्पोक अबाउट, सो दैट यू कैन हैव एक्सक्लूसिव अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑन कार्ल मार्क्स. Besides your, because it is very much related to your topics only. Are you getting these points? So what you have to see, you need to see the model notes which I am going to say, give it to you. So they will be like, you know, I will just see some. एक notes आपको भी मिल जाएगा, mail आ जाएगा ओम सर से. उसको देखो, पढ़ो, समझो. ठीक है? So that is actually note of this PDF only. ठीक है? So जो मैंने क्लास में डिक्टेट कराया एंड ऑल दैट, सो दे आर सम एस्पिरेंट्स जो बहुत लाइक यू नो सिस्टमैटिक पढ़ते हैं एंड ऑल दैट, फिर जो मेरे मेंटरशिप प्रोग्राम में भी आ जाते हैं, जो पूरे अपने नोट्स वगैरह चेक कराते हैं मेरे से. उसके बाद आई लाइक यू नो सी देयर बेस्ट नोट्स, ऑल राइट, एंड विच आई हैव डिक्टेटेड, ऑल राइट, सो यू कैन जस्ट सी देम जस्ट एज मॉडल, राइट. सो रीड इट बट डू नॉट जस्ट कंप्लीटली फॉलो दैट. आपको सिर्फ समझना है कि इस पीडीएफ्स को किस तरीके से इंपॉर्टेंट वे में पढ़ना है. ऑलराइट, नाउ अबाउट ह्यूमन पोटेंशियल, प्लीज राइट डाउन अबाउट ह्यूमन पोटेंशियल. क्लास स्ट्रगल तो समझ में आ गया, क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस, राइट डाउन क्लास स्ट्रगल, क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस, राइट डाउन क्लास कॉन्शियसनेस. Human potential. Karl Marx is basically talking about human potential. In what manner? Why he was actually against capitalism? That we have to understand. In what manner he is talking about? So he was basically a humanistic, and he is talking about human potential. So he says that what is happening when we are having one class, that is of workers, we are limiting potential of humans. His concept of human potential leads to us to alienation. He says that capitalism is a very good production system. It's a very good economical production system because it is what it should help to reach human to its maximum potential. What it is? Now, because of machineries, because of technologies, we are having large scale of production. So now we have large scale of production. We have maximum food. We have got maximum foods, right? So we have got different resources. Now humans do not have to worry about their survival. So now survival is not an issue. Survival is not an issue. But what is happening? Because of capitalism, human potential is being challenged. It is we who has created machines. It is we who has created, you know, all materialistic things which we see around us. It is we who had given the concept of sun, moon, you know, we have gone to moons. It is humans. But what is capitalism is doing? Capitalism is producing the conditions. Capitalism is producing conditions where humans have become like machines. So they have become like machine through a systematic process of alienation. So capitalism is limiting human progress. Why? Because it alienates humans. How? It alienates humans with his production, whatsoever he is producing. No emotional connection. So when I don't feel emotionally connected with my production, I will not want to progress. I will see कि मैं क्यों इतना काम करूं, पैसा तो capitalist को जा रहा है, ठीक है? तो मेरा कोई control ही नहीं है मेरे production में. तो पहले तो मैं production से ही मेरा emotional detachment हो गया. दूसरा, किससे detachment हो गया? I will not have social life. मेरी खुद की social life नहीं है. बल्कि मेरे वर्कर्स जो मेरे कलीग्स हैं उनसे ही हम नहीं मिल पाते, राइट? नो सोशल लाइफ. जब सोशल लाइफ नहीं है, फैमिली लाइफ अच्छी नहीं है, आई विल हैव मोर फ्रस्ट्रेशन. और दूसरा, जब मैं मशीन की तरह बन गई हूं तो आई विल हैव सेल्फ एलिनेशन टू. आई डू नॉट नो व्हाट आई वांट. सेल्फ एलिनेशन. ओके, अपने भी तो आप क्या सोच रहे हो ये भी तो नहीं पता ना हमको. जब हम मशीन्स की तरह काम कर रहे हैं 12-15 घंटे, सोशल लाइफ नहीं है. तो जब आप मशीन की तरह काम कर रहे हैं उसको ये जो वर्क प्रेशर होता है लेबर्स का, सो व्हाट दे डू, दे ड्रिंक, दे डू अल्कोहल. हेल्दी लाइफ नहीं है, अच्छी सोशल लाइफ नहीं है. आप यू डू नॉट नो योर पोटेंशियल, यू जस्ट बिकम अ मशीन. व्हाट यू वांट, व्हाट गुड यू कैन डू इन योर लाइफ, it is being challenged. Okay, are you understanding? So they all are just busy to get for their survival. Capitalism to achhi cheez honi chahiye jahan pe survival is not an issue, but it become an issue because every time you are just thinking about food, shelter, basic necessities. So what is happening? Problem is that the concentration of wealth. Capitalist is keeping their all profit with themselves. And they are not sharing, they are not giving good portion to labors which they want. So ab dekho human potential kya ho gaya? Human potential challenged ho gaya. Samajh mein aa gaya? Human potential ka role samajh mein aa gaya? So human potential is actually telling us that how alienation come. So there is only one class who is getting benefited, that is bourgeoisie. And other class is being exploited. All right. So now he says that how does capitalism emerged? So next question can be quickly. All right. That how capitalism has come up. So in this PDF, it is their power and needs. Write down. So according to Karl Marx, it is power and needs which has created capitalism. So what's needs? So needs are the desires people feel needs are the desire people feel for things that are usually not immediately available. Okay. I'm going to tell all this, okay? Ke baad we have got 3 minutes. You will see from your notes which will be given to you. So he says that capitalism is basically created because of power and needs, right? So he says that what had happened? Here, Karl Marx and Durkheim, you know, they are during the concept of alienation, Karl Marx and Durkheim got on the same page. So what you have to say that actually what is happening? That humans have less consciousness. Okay, that I will explain tomorrow, acche se completely. So he says that humans have started having low consciousness or no consciousness. And how does it come? Because of our orientation, because of our perception of power and needs. Capitalism have now. Capitalist mode of production or industrialization have created enough food for everyone to survive. But with industrialization, with capitalist mode of production, what we have, we also had got the notion of power. Now world wants to have power. Okay, so this power led them to exploit. Okay. And why do we have this notion of power? Because we do not have consciousness. So when human do not have consciousness, when they don't feel that it is their duty to look after the needs of others class too, then they start doing exploitation and they act like animals. Okay, so we do have needs for survival. But what you will do for the needs of illusions, materialistic illusions. So we do need telephone, we need phone to communicate, right? We do need phone to communicate, but what is happening now? We want iPhone only. Shelter is important, but we want mahal only. Good life is important, but we want luxuries only. Okay, so this is what we are going to discuss tomorrow. Basically, what is human needs? So you need to understand why capitalism flourished according to Karl Marx. These are the questions you should write, and you should know what is commodification, what is fetishism of commodification, and I'm going to read and explain you from the PDF. Okay, so what you people have to do, you should just read the PDF systematically. आपको समझ में नहीं आएगा क्योंकि बहुत थोड़ा सा philosopher manner में आता है, लेकिन अगर आप इस class को सुनने के बाद read करोगे तो आपको PDF सब समझ में आएगी, ठीक है? और PDF को आप immediately पढ़ो, otherwise आप लोगों के लिए problematic हो जाएगा. So let's just finish this class now, and I will tell Abhishek. Abhi, I need to be done with my batch 2. ठीक है, तो अभी I'm occupied with batch 2. So let me just done with my batch 2 aspirants. Then I will see. Okay. And because of last Saturday, my schedule got disturbed. So maybe from next 2 Saturdays or so, I will just try to see. Do not worry, I see everyone notes. Okay? On the basis of your notes only, I take people under my mentorship program. All right, guys. So thank you so very much. Take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.